So the subtopic now, you can call it review. So generally, if you take a look at the reference sheet of paper, you will see that the formulas of trigonometric identities are sine squared theta plus cos squared theta equal to 1. And then that the other one is it 1 plus tan squared theta equal to, is it sec squared theta? Let me be sure. I think it is sec. Yes, it is sec squared theta. And then the other one is 1 cot and cosec. So the third one is 1 plus cot squared theta is equal to cosec squared theta. Now, typically, many questions that relate to trig identities, you will be given one of the trigonometric ratios, the value of one of the trigonometric ratios, and you will be asked to find the other. Okay? You'll be asked to find the other. For example, the question could be like this. The question could be, given that, let me write it, then we read it. Okay, so given that tangent theta is equal to 3/4, determine the secant of the angle and the cosecant. So that's how the question can be like that, can be framed in this way. So now if that is the case, so typically what you would do to help you in solving that would be, if I were you, I would just sketch the triangle. I would sketch the triangle. So generally you write solution, and in that solution you sketch the triangle. Remember, the question didn't say sketch triangle, but you are sketching the triangle because it is going to help you create a visual representation of the situation. So if you're sketching the triangle, it's going to be like this. It's a right triangle, and this is your theta. And remember your secatua, always. That's the key. Secatua, always write it. Secatua. And this is your 90 degree. And it tells you that given that tangent is 3/4. So from secatua, tan itself is equal to opposite over adjacent. So when it says tangent theta, tan theta is 3/4. That means the opposite is 3. So this is the opposite is 3. This is the adjacent, it is 4. The hypotenuse, we don't know, but this is hypotenuse. We probably don't need the hypotenuse. So now what's next we need to do? We need to take this value and substitute it to trig ratio, to the Pythagorean identity, which is this one. So the next thing we will do would be, we just write 1/1 plus 3/4 whole squared is equal to sec squared theta. Okay, so 3/4 squared means 3 squared divided by 4 squared. So 3 squared is 9/16 equal to, not equal to, plus 1/1, and that's equal to sec squared theta. All right. So to solve this, you need to solve the left side. You need to evaluate the left side. So the left side you can write as 16/16 plus 9/16 equal to sec squared theta. So let me create this space here because I don't have space below. So now, because look at the denominator. The denominator is now the same. So you just pick one of them. So sec squared theta is equal to 16. And then because they have common denominator. So 16 plus 9. So would that give you, what would that give you on the numerator?
25
divided by 16. So now, this is sec squared theta. So you need to square root both sides. So square root both sides. All right. So that's going to give you If you square root sec square theta, it's going to give you square root of sec square theta will is equal to, hold on, let me create space below. I didn't really want to, don't worry. Sec square theta is equal to square root of 25 over 16. And that should give us 5 over 4. So that's sec square theta. Sec square theta is 5 over 4. Now, that's just one part of the question. The question also says that we should find cosecant of the angle. Cosecant of the angle, which is, all right. So let me go to a completely new page. Give me a moment. So second part says find cosecant of the angle. All right. So once again, you'll be using Pythagorean identity. And among that three formulas, which one do you think we should use this time around? Look at the formulas I wrote earlier. Look at the formulas, three of them. So which one?
Cotangent and
cotangent equals cosec.
Okay, so we should use one. Say the full formula. So we can use 1 plus cot square theta equal to cosec square theta. So they are looking for secant here, cosecant rather. So it is better to use the formula that has cosecant already. Okay. So now remember that you were given. Hold on. Give me 1 second. Okay. So remember that you were given that tangent tan theta is equal to 3 over 4. That's what you were given originally. And you also know that cot is equal to cotangent by itself is equal to 1 over tangent. And cotangent is also equal to adjacent over opposite. So this is basic trig ratio, this one, basic identity. So what that then means is, since you already given tangent, so cotangent, just flip the number. So just flip the number. So which means cot theta. Cot theta would be 4 over 3. So if cot theta is 4 over 3, all you need to do now is plug it in back into the equation. Plug this thing back here. So that should give us 1 over 1 plus 4 over 3 whole squared equal to cosec square theta. All right. So this is going to give us 1 over 1 plus 16 over 9 equal to cosec square theta. And then you just repeat the same process that we did. So evaluate the left hand side. So evaluating the left hand side means you can write 16 divided by 16 plus 16 divided by 9 and is still equal to cosec squared theta. I made a mistake. Hold on. It should be 9 over 9, not 16 over 9, because you would like to get the denominator the same, common denominator. So it should be 9 over 9. Okay. So in that case, you will add the common denominator is 9, so you add the numerator, so which will be 25, and that's equal to cosec square theta. So if you square root both sides, so you square root 25 over 9 equal to square root of cosec squared theta. All right, so which will give us 5 over 3 equal to cosec square theta. And that's your solution. I'm sorry, equal to cosec theta rather, not cosec square theta. So that's how to do it, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Mr. Yu.
All right. So now
I have a question.
Yes, hold on. Yeah, what's your question? Go ahead.
Since when we found what the hypotenuse was solving the first one, why didn't we just like plug it up? Like, you know how like we did the six trig ratios? Why didn't we just do it like that?
Because we are trying to illustrate Pythagorean identity. That's the reason. If the question says solve the find the all those things without asking you the particular method to do, you can do that immediately. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
The reason why I use Pythagorean identity is because somebody requested that we should illustrate that, we should review it. So if the question was just given tangent is equal to 3/4, and then find secant and cosecant, you don't need to use Pythagorean theorem. You can use the other one to get it immediately. That's actually shorter. Did I answer the question?
Yes.
Okay. So, but it is important. It is important that everybody knows how to use the Pythagorean identity, because many questions will ask you to use Pythagorean identity. And besides, this has given us an opportunity to illustrate adding and manipulating fractions. Yes. So that's where we are right now.